Good morning, student. Today I am going to start a new chapter of English workbook, that is lesson 3, The Selfish Gent. And student, this story is just resemble of the story, The Robin Who Sowed the Way, which I taught earlier in online class. And that story I told how Mary got the key and how she found the secret garden and with the help of Robin the bird, and how she entered the secret garden. So this is also about another garden that was walled in by the selfish gent. So let's start the chapter. Student, this story started during a winter season, and there was a big and lovely garden whose owner was a gent. And in this garden there was a soft green grasses and beautiful flowers also. Even so many trees are there, and birds always sat on the tree and sang beautifully. And that is why so many children were happy to play there. So one day when gent, who visited his friend for the last 7 years, came back and he saw there was a children playing in the garden, he shouted, he cried angrily and he said, "What are you doing here, children? This is my garden, this is my own garden." And after listening this threatened, this horrible voice, the children ran away in fright. Then after, the gent decided to build a high wall all around the garden, so no one have come into the garden. And that time the children could no longer visit the garden, and then the poor children now had nowhere to play. They always wander round the high wall, and they said to one another, "How happy we are in the garden." And the spring winter season gone, and the spring season came. So all over the country there were beautiful flowers, therefore there were beautiful blossoms and little birds, but only in the garden of selfish gent, even in still winter. And there the bird did not care to sing, because there were no children, even the trees forgot to blossom. So one day the selfish gent sat in the window and looked out his cold white garden, and he said himself, "I cannot understand why spring is so late in coming." And then he hoped it may be there will be change in the weather, but it not happened. Even spring never come in the garden, so there was only winter. All the trees were laden with snow, and north wind, the hail and the frost all over came in the here on the gent garden. So one day the gent was laying awake in bed, and he heard some lovely music, and he saw a linnet was singing outside his window, and delicious perfume came to him through the window. So he believed that maybe spring had come, and suddenly he jumped out of the bed and looked out. And what he saw? He saw a most wonderful sight. He saw a little hole in the wall, and children had crept in, and they were sitting on the each branches of the tree. And he saw every tree that he could see, there was a little children. And the tree were also so glad to have the children back again, and they had covered with the blossoms. Even the birds were flying about, and the flowers were looking up through the green grass. And it was a lovely scene which saw by the gent. And then gent realized that he had been very selfish, and he said himself, "How selfish I have been now. I know why spring would not come here." So he decided, suddenly, "I will knock down the wall, and my garden shall be the children's playground forever and ever." He was really very sorry for that he done, and that he said to children, "It is your garden, children. Now you come and play." And then he took a great axe and knocked down the wall. And then after, the children were always came into the garden of selfish gent, not selfish gent, but a gent, and they played happily. And that time the trees blossoms, birds singing, flowers blossoms, and all the scenes was very cheerful. And then after, the children's always came and Gent looked happily. So this is the story. I hope you all will understand and you all enjoy it. So today's your homework is just read this chapter once again and mug up all the hard work from this chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.